there. It's time to peel back a new layer of our series on analytics engineering with Dataform. Today, we embark on an exploration of data testing, a critical concept also known as assertions. Can you imagine the mountains of data assets in our BigQuery system? It's with a Sherlock Holmes-like meticulousness that we run through these data assets, testing each one to assure its quality and accuracy. A quick reminder from earlier parts of the series, we employ an extract load pipeline within BigQuery data transfer. You could similarly use Fivetran for the extract and load processes. Meanwhile, we wield Dataform, one of BigQuery's trusty tools, to manage our transformations and operations. Check the description below this video for our Git repository link, where we've shared all the data assets and code. Since Dataform is free, you can follow along without cost concerns. Our raw data is in this YouTube BigQuery dataset, while the derived data resides in the YouTube Analytics dataset. The data platform scripts lie in Dataform, including our transformations and source declarations. We start with some source declarations, work our way into staging layers, and then finish with the mentions and facts. Now, let's navigate the complex yet intriguing world of assertion types and their implementation. Let's first consider the geography transformation, where we've woven a non-null assertion in place for different columns. It's a cinch to use, apply, and test. Makes you feel like a pro, doesn't it? More complex validations are done with row conditions. Here, for example, we could assert that the average view duration must always sit between 0 and 1. As you dive deeper into the built-in assertions, you'll find more options like unique keys. But when things get too complex, we fall back to custom manual assertions. We'll apply a manual assertion to the demographics dimension. We fire up a new file and set up an assertion configuration block. Then it's time to examine the country code, confirming that no invalid country codes sneak into our dataset, like ZZZ. Success in these tests means we've avoided any data problems. Taking it a step further, imagine that we only want to create the geographies fact once our assertion passes successfully. This makes sense, to limit the blast radius of issues. We wouldn't want to propagate data problems across all layers of our data platform. In this scenario, we use a manual dependency on our assertion. Now, each time our code is run, a green light from the assertion test is needed before our data refreshes. It's like a pre-departure flight check. Whether you're leaning towards manual assertions, sticking with the built-in assertions, or both, it's often wise to add the assertions as dependencies. After cataloging our notes, we've officially wrapped up the series. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.